Okay, so I have money. I don't remember what I was doing. I got a bunch of rhubarb. Oh, right. We're slowly trying to prep for... What the hell's up with the weird duck stack? That's creepy. Is, Fluffles here? Yep, there's Fluffles. I have no idea where the exit is considered in this one. Should probably look into that. Should probably also consider putting the mayo machines in here at some point. No. There we go. Let's do that. Everything's looking good on this end. Okay, let's drop the eggs off. So my inventory is pretty clear, which is nice. Yeah, I have no idea where I was going with the last episode run. So let's just keep working on rhubarb. Now we've got 8 days left before the we got 8 days left before the starfruit's done. And once actually no, we'll get the starfruit and the melons almost at the same time, which is going to be super helpful for us, because once we get the melons, we're probably going to get the community center done, and then we can start working on the let's not drop the battery. Let's drop the rhubarb wine, the rhubarb jelly, diamond. Don't need any of those. Okay. But once we get the melon, we get the community center, then we can start working on the greenhouse, which is going to be amazing. I wanted to get rid of this just because it was bothering me. Okay, so we've got that taken care of. Now what? Chop trees, I guess. I should probably go deal with the rest of my, deal with the rest of my farm. The main issue is, what the heck do I do with my, what the heck do I do with, like, this area? I think you were trying to do the casino quest. Right! So we need to check the beaches. And stuff. I also want to max out my foraging if I can. So let's start chopping down these random trees here. We've got a nice little pine tree farm, but we don't really need it to be there. Okay. But yeah, let's we'll check the beach, because if I can get the rainbow shell, that puts me in a really, really nice spot. I think what I might actually do for this part of the yard is just cover it in grass at some point. Let's see. Speaking of grass. So it doesn't threaten my flowers, though I guess it never would. That witch there always screws with my head just a little bit. Because I don't expect there to be a witch there. And so I think there's actually like a legit witch character that's just creeping in my property. Which I'm not totally okay with. Okay, so we've got till the 8th. The 8th is when Gus's birthday rolls around. He likes diamonds. So that's good. Okay. Yeah, we already got Jazz. Oops, going the wrong way. Already got Jazz. It's Friday, so we need to stop by the gypsy. Make sure that we have our bases covered just in case I can get the pomegranate. And a rainbow shell. Kinda wish I had saved one of those or paid more attention, but honestly I would have had no way of knowing. Okay. People are talking about furries in chats. I mean, I knew like one furry in high school, and we were friends, but his insistence on including his furry identity in everything was weird. Sewer Dude has iridium sprinklers on Fridays. Oh yeah, that's a good point. Let's stop there. I got so much money that we might as well blow it on Sewer Dude stuff. Okay. Speaking of My Little Pony, how long do you think it'll be till someone makes a My Little Pony mod for Stardew? Oh, that already happened! That's... If you go check the mod page, there is My Little Pony, My Little Pony stuff. For Stardew Valley. I saw it and I was like, huh. Alright, let's keep going. Luckily that fad is like, just like faded away really, really nicely. I don't know. I'm not I'm not against My Little Pony, but I also had a really intense brony roommate in college, and that was interesting. He was a nice guy, but he, like, lived My Little Pony for a while. And that was a problem. I saw the cherry bomb and I got excited for a second. Okay, yeah, these are meaningless. Okay. So now what? It's pretty much all the seasonal stuff that we need to care about. We have another iridium sprinkler. Which I might as well put on the ground. If we've got the... Do we have the stone? We don't have any stone here. Let's go get some stone and I'll put the iridium sprinkler up. Because we might as well have the thing. Hey! Unfortunately, these are just wild honey for the time being. And we get another battery. Useful. Okay, so we dropped the batteries off. We actually got 5 batteries from that, and we already used one. So I guess getting hit by those lightning rods actually produced more than one. That's good to know. Okay, so we want 1 stone. Right? Stone. There we go. And we might as well drop off some of the tree-related junk that we picked up, like sap and wood. Okay, inventory's looking nice and clear. That's good. Krovis is forever known as Sewer Dude.
Yeah!
Sewer Dude. Okay, so we want 1, 2, 3. And that. I'm probably not going to plant anything there until the next season, just because I want people to pay a whole lot of attention to it. Okay. Alternatively, I could just buy 24 seeds for melons. Oh, right. Let's get the scarecrows down just in case something decides to come. But yeah, let's go buy 24 melon seeds, seeing as I have nothing better to do. There. Okay. I was gonna... Oh, right. I'm not crafting anything. I'm just plonking these down. Of course, it's going to make it a bit of a pain in the ass getting horse through, but whatever. It'll be okay. So let's see, what else do we want to do? So we need 24 melon seeds. We got a lot of mayo and honey that we can drop off, so that's good. Gee, I honestly don't know. I guess we could go back to stalking people now. Now that friendship doesn't decay, which is kind of handy. Accidentally skipped a day in fall because you upgraded your house and didn't realize that your bed was bigger. Whoops! That's sad. That's a sad thing. I have not actually had that happen yet, come to think of it. Okay, so blueberries, yeah, are useless. We could try and go for more melons. We've already got the red cabbage. So yeah, let's just go with melons. Oh, wait, I was supposed to do 24. Eh, close enough. Wait, how much do the melon seeds sell back for? Oh, I see. Yeah, obviously not enough, but barely any loss there. Okay, that's good. So back on the horse, and we'll just go drop these things off. I guess I'll water the crops. Though it really doesn't make much of a difference, we might as well get the extra day in there. It still bothers me that the sprinklers only sprinkle in the morning. That makes no sense to me. Like, if you got a sprinkler near something, you should just totally, you should totally just be able to, trigger the sprinklers and suddenly, bada boosh. There you go. Okay, so we want to do right here. Okay. Whomever told me the tip about put something underneath the sprinkler, you are a wonderful person, and I like you for the things that you do for this stream. Okay, so yeah, let's just do more melons. Technically, probably should have, I should have done some things, like, fertilize them, but whatever. I don't care that much, and chances are whatever we get is going to be really useful. Okay, so let's get this, and, I guess let's go grab the iridium. I've got a lot of money here. So let's go upgrade the hoe. Because we obviously are gonna always need an iridium hoe. We don't need an iridium pick that much, or an iridium axe, but absolutely an iridium An iridium hoe will make life a lot easier for me. I'm trying to think of what else there is. Yeah, gee, not much. Well, that works. Okay. Because I don't need to go fishing. We're done for the season. Because I think literally there's one fish left and it's in the fall. There's no cooking show. There's nothing. It's... Oh, shoot. It's 5 p.m. Well, I wasted too much time. I was not paying attention. Oopsie. Oh, well. Iridium axe cuts down a tree in 3 whacks. Yeah. But that really doesn't make, like, much of a difference for me. Like, right now, I'm in a fine position to just not cut down trees very often. Like, the golden one is generally good enough here. Okay, yeah, let's just go to bed. I got nothing better to do. Get out of my way. I wonder what I'm gonna do when I get... Oh, shoot. You know what I haven't done? I haven't bothered to deal with these guys over here. Probably should. Do I still... I still have the bucket and the shears. Chances are they don't... They're not ready for a Melkin, but whatever. Nope, they are ready for a Melkin. Huzzah! Okay, that makes my life easier, though. I don't know where the sheep is. Sheep hanging out inside like a lazy bones? Sheep is hanging out inside like a lazy bones. Oh, sheep is definitely not ready for being a being sheared, though. It wouldn't... What? Did they all just, like, mystically go inside while I was... Weird. They did. Okay. Oh, we got that. Are there any special events on Saturday? Because Sunday is cooking show. Yeah, I don't think there's anything else. All right, that's fine. I haven't checked the Bat Cave in a while. I haven't checked the Bat Cave in a while, but it also doesn't matter that much, because the Bat Cave slowly builds up its stock anyway. What was that noise? I don't know, but it just made a lot of money. Oh! That means my house is completed. Oh. No, it's not. Fisherman wanted, I need a good puffer fish specimen. I'm conducting an experiment on toxin created by the puffer fish. So we need to go get us a puffer fish. I don't think I have one of those. Can somebody look up when and where you get the puffer fish? Because I don't remember. I should probably also let these run fallow just for a second. At some point. Just so I can get them all synced. Because I'm kind of sick and tired of managing all of the wine and whatnot. Is there anybody else? There's the duck. There we go. Which fish? Puffer fish. When and where would be preferable, because I have honestly no idea with each. Okay. Let's see, get out of my way. Let's see, so we got eggs. Ocean, summer, 12 to 4. Okay. Well, I guess we'll go do that one, because I think that boosts friendship for Demetrius. And I also have generally nothing better to do with myself. Like, that's part of it, it's just like, eh. I mean, we could do other things. We really, honestly could go out of our way. But it just doesn't matter to me. Actually, let's not bring the horse in here. I don't want to get on and off constantly. We should also consider moving the chickens over to this yard. Maybe. Or selling the chickens at some point. Have I made my millions with starfruit yet? No, that is actually going to be a really, really long process. Because that's taking care of gypsies tomorrow, cooking shows tomorrow. Two days before anything. Oh, let's go get the hoe set up. I have no idea what the iridium hoe's like area of effect is, but it's got to be huge. I hope. Oh, convenient. That would be convenient at least. Hey, Donovan. Yes, I am organized. Not being organized bothers me. Unless you're saying that in a sarcastic manner, and then I'd be like, what? I'm pretty organized here. Except for the occasional, like, production thing that I'm not paying attention to. Okay, Iridium Ho. There we go. So we'll hop back on this, and I guess we might as well just go fishing for the rest of the day. What does sewer guy sell on days like today? Can I get past Alex here? I should be able to. I like how just like two of the dudes are just staring at the river. Does nobody have lives in this, Oh. On Fridays he does something... Okay. Bye, sewer guy. Okay, it's either 6x3 or 6x6. That's really good, actually. What's my current sword? It's the Lava Katana. I know there's, like, one better than it. Oh, right, I need to be... I don't have my hoe. I can't dig that up. I know I need to be searching for the rainbow shell, and I kind of forgot. Doesn't look like we got it, though, unfortunately. Okay, well, let's just go fishing. And just spend the day doing that, because what... I mean, truly... What do I do with myself, man? I don't know. So we'll just go until we get a puffer fish. Because, yeah, everything else is pretty much coming up perfect for this run. For this season. It's the one sad thing about this game. There's no, like, overarching financial goals for me right now. I'm gonna try and fix my chair. There we go. Now I can lean back proper. Oh shit, this thing, what the fuck was that? Whatever that fish was, I ain't catching it. I also don't care to go looking for, like, the really hard ones. Like, people are telling me to go for the legendaries at some point, I'm like, meh. Well, there's the tilapia we would have needed. I could do crab pots if I don't have any. I have grab pots. They're just a pain in the ass to grab them. Do you think that was a puffer fish? Really? Well, we'll get that. There we go. Okay, so what are we getting here? A rusty spur. Huh. Yeah, the one other thing I haven't done is gone fishing for artifacts yet. Because I need to do fishing for artifacts, because I think that's the only place I haven't gotten artifacts from. I guess technically there's also the, apart from fishing for artifacts, we also haven't been digging for them particularly well. Though I think that's a little bit less common. It's hard to say. What happened to crab pots being useless? I mean, they might actually be useful for something. But I have yet to actually see them be good for anything. Buffer fish? No, tuna. Oh. I don't know, they just kept getting junk in them. Like glasses and broken CDs, and I'm like, well, this is just stupid. It's not worth my time. Because I already got all the community center stuff for the crab pot, so it's like, meh. Not gonna bother. Okay, it's still Saturday. Monday is What's-His-Face's birthday. Yeah, I think it was just a really aggressive large tuna, is my bet. Could be wrong on that one, though. Well, we should be in puffer fish time. And worst comes to worst, we just stick around until the gypsy has a puffer fish. Because it's not like I'm expecting a whole lot of financial gain. This is probably the puffer fish. Okay, come on. Focus time. Yeah, this is probably it. Either that or a very aggressive tuna here. Fuck, it does not want to get caught. Luckily, my fishing skill is maxed. This kind of shit sucks otherwise. Puffer fish! Alright, let's go turn that into Demetrius.
Oh,
I was talking to Shell about, I was talking to Shell about, like, how you guys keep, mentioning that I should romance somebody in this game. And I mentioned that I'm in love with my vegetables and that I ride Birdcatcher every day. And she laughed menacingly. I'm not sure if I'm doing this right. After the puffer fish time, you can try for the legendary summer fish. Or I could just not, because I don't really care that much. Like, the concept of going out of my way to get a legendary fish is just like, eh, it sounds like work. It's Demetrius. Not home. I don't know why he'd be in his awkward son's basement, but whatever. Oh, right. That reminds me. She has shit I can buy. Like a calendar. That's important. Let's see, what else can we get? A stump seat, that's kind of neat. Should probably get windows at some point. Let's buy a window. I'm gonna do some home decoration stuff for a bit. Let's buy the recipes, because some of these seem kind of cool. Oh, that was a crystal path. We'll buy the plasma TV. We will buy the oak tea table, the walnut end table, and another budget TV. Let's see, can I buy the little tree? Okay, that's a yes. That was a complete waste of money. What else am I going to use it for? We don't have enough cash to get that, like, special thing, whatever it's called. Didn't I need a puffer fish for the bundle? I've already got the bundle completed. So, not even. I'm truly set on these things. As an adorable house. Let's fill it with shit. Anything else? There we go. Okay, I think we're good. So, got the plasma TV. And then we've got another budget TV. Oh, I see. So they work the same way. Gotcha. Let's see. Oak end table. Oh, that's actually a lot smaller. Oh, this is the calendar. Whoops. Oh, that's not nearly as small as I thought it was going to be. Okay, so we'll just put that there. This is probably going to end up in my way, so let's move that back there. We'll put that there. Put that there. Okay, I have a window. We'll put it, like, right here. Placed on a wall. Placed on a wall? What the fuck if this is a wall? Do I have to, like, put it here? Oh, there it is. Huh. Weird. This is confusing. Okay, oh right, we also have the painting. What? Must also be placed on a wall. These don't count? Alright, there we go. Well, let's go sell our mayonnaise, I guess. I've already dealt with my animals, we should be good. So we'll sell these. I guess let's hop back on horse and go look for Demetrius. I'm sure we'll find him at some point. He might even be heading home at this point, too. It is hard to say. Oh, this game is peaceful. Sometimes nice to just kind of, like, relax and stuff. Okay. What's a topic to talk about? Oh, man. I woke up, so I wake up every day, and I read my emails to see, I wake up every day, and where the hell's your husband? This is just an inconvenience. I'm just gonna stand outside their door until they come back, I guess. You know what? I'm gonna sit outside the door in a goddamn butt stallion. There we go. I'm just gonna wait here until Demetrius comes by. Oh yeah, let's grab the puffer fish. Gold star. I wonder if they can get past my horse. That's an interesting question. I have no idea. Try downstairs. Nah, that's where his son's room is, and I can't get in there. Alright, so I'm gonna block the door with Birdcatcher. I'm gonna stand near this pufferfish, and we're gonna see if I can force them to never go to bed. I'm gonna just wait here. let's see. I love that you modded your horse into a unicorn. Hell yeah! It was either this or Rapidash, which was tempting, but I thought the unicorn was better. Okay. This is how you awkwardly force conversations with people, you know, from personal experience. Yeah! Alright, so my hope is they'll get stuck. Anyway, so I was telling a story. I was telling a story. Okay, so every day I wake up and read emails. Now, for the most part, it's like benign, just comments, you know, Wander love your vids, notice me senpai, so on and so forth. Okay, so let's see if she can brave the horse. Oh, motherfucker, there's a second door. Okay, I'm gonna block. They could just go straight through the horse. It's hard to really grasp the scale of the universe. God damn it, the roadblock didn't work. Okay. Okay, let's switch this up now. It's... fuck. Okay, there's Demetrius. Pufferfish! There you are. The specimen looks perfect. I'm gonna get it on ice straight away. Thanks, dude. Okay, so now we are going to stand in the way of his house on Butt Stallion. Okay, so if I'm there, he can't go past. And then he gets angry at me and quickly rushes inside. Haha! I've never tried that before. Okay, that's cool. But yeah, anyway, so story time. Sorry, I read my emails, obviously. I want to see what you people are saying. I should not have done that, honestly. Whatever. You know, I want to see what you people are saying. I want to see if there's relevant information I should probably keep in mind. Yada, yada, yada. Unfortunately, every once in a while I get, like, emails, you know, from the shittier dregs of YouTube. And, I mean, you guys know who you are. And it's probably none of you that are listening to this right now. Live, probably. I don't know, maybe. Some of you guys could be assholes, and I don't know. Or I do know, and you know, and then we've just kind of come to a nice little agreement there. But so, this one guy was angry at me because I only tell stories about, this one guy was angry at me because I only tell stories about, like, high school and college and stuff. And then proceeded to call me a white, stick-thin, pasty nerd. I mean, it's true that I do mostly tell stories about, like, you know, prior life and stuff. Just because, like, am I gonna tell you guys what happened when I was filming, like, another episode? This is a weird problem that I'm having in life now, where... you know, I've got a lot of stories to tell, you know, my family, associated people. I don't have stories to tell you guys after a while. Like, I'm gonna run out someday. And it's not a problem for me, necessarily, because I'm always gonna have stuff to talk about. It just might not necessarily be... I thought he said he was gonna give me 1,000 gold. What a jip. Okay. But, oh right, Sunday, gotta go watch one of the many TVs that I currently... can I watch the TV from the side? Yes! Okay, Queen of Sauce. Okay, Carp Surprise. Cool. Yeah, stories about food and stuff like that. But so this guy was accusing me of being, you know, more or less wasting my life playing video games and stuff. Yeah, the letter did say 1,000. I'm not crazy. That's... I probably should have mayo machined here. Oh, whatever. But I was thinking about it, and honestly, I was kind of offended because, you know, obviously somebody's insulted me. Of course, I'm going to feel mild amounts of, you know, I'm going to feel mildly offended. If anybody offends you, you're probably going to be slightly chuffed about it. Whether or not it's actually, like, legit, I don't know. Stand still and let me milk you. That guy seems really weird. And, yeah, bro, I mean, I have no idea what kind of person this is. It'd be easier if I actually knew, you know, who they were and what they did, but obviously I don't, so I have to make conjecture based on this person. But gonna be honest, anybody that goes onto a YouTube video and watches the entire thing and then insults the YouTuber for their lifestyle, that leads me to believe that they're honestly just as much of a waste of, space and time as I am, if not worse. Because, like, I'm not going to say this out of, like, true spite, because, honestly, at this point, it's just kind of an interesting to think about more than, like, me being offended. Okay, can I... Oh, I gotta put it on a wall. God damn it. Alright, I guess I'll just put it next to the bed like everything else. Okay. So tomorrow we have to get him a diamond, so we might as well carry that around just because. Yeah, there will always be haters. It's true. But, gets to me mildly, and I have to think about it just because. But, I mean, for starters, there's that. But it really did actually get me thinking, like, you know, what am I going to talk about when I'm, like, 27, 28, 30? Like, I'm probably still going to be doing YouTube. Honestly, it probably won't matter. I'll have a lot of other stuff to do. Oh, shit, they did actually take a crop there. Sons of bitches. Yeah, let's take this one. Probably doesn't need to be here. In fact, let's move them all closer. This seems like a reasonable spot. There's still going to be a slight lack of coverage, but still. There we go. Might be a doctor who saves lives. Not defending him, just saying. Honestly, anybody that watches at least 30-40 minutes into episode 30 of Rampage Nights probably isn't a life-saving doctor. I could be very wrong on that one. But my bet is, I feel like most of these people are just as bad as me, or children, and it's like, honestly, yeah, I'm probably gonna say, like, young teens, preteens, is usually the, like, rudest people. Like, I will be totally frank, there are very, very asinine adults out there. Like, we all know them, we've seen them, but for the most part, it's... You know, for the most part, it's usually younger kids. I could be wrong. I actually saw a, there's a comic. I don't know which person does this comic, honestly. I should probably pay attention to this. I saw a Reddit thread, a little while ago about, it was like, kind of one of those standard, gamer ones, maybe? But it was effectively making fun of how... somebody was making fun of somebody for watching YouTube, and then immediately went off to go watch, pro sports. And, you know, I decided to read the Reddit thread just because I was interested in seeing what people said. I'm a teen and I'm not rude. I don't troll. Yeah, yeah, I'm not gonna say it's, like, all children. I'm just saying it's either... Most likely these people that are, like, attacking me as a person generally tend to be on the younger side just because they don't have a whole lot of good ammo, for, like, insulting somebody. Just because, whatever. Could be wrong. I mean, he truly could be anyone. I just, personal experience has led me to believe it's usually younger audience members to be weirdly angry about things. But obviously not all of them. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, so I was reading this Reddit thread. And I was thinking about it, and, you know, I was thinking, like, you know, I really want to see what the hive mind thinks about these things. And I was actually kind of impressed to see that the entirety of the thread was effectively bashing YouTube and YouTubers, saying that, you know, it's not the same. That, you know, pro sports, you can't do, but you could just as easily play video games. So therefore, it's a false comparison. You can't say that watching pro sports is the same as, like, watching a YouTuber and stuff. Except for, like, maybe pro players and whatever. But it was fascinating to see the argument, just because... For me, it's kind of a no-brainer, thinking, you know... Yeah, I would actually consider, you know, watching YouTubers to be not unlike watching, you know, sports people or stuff like that. Let's see.